Hey everybody, CEO Matthew Six here, coming to you with my first episode from this new series, which I'm going to entitle BS, also known as Battle and a Story. Now, last year, I tried out for the golf team, and I knew I was going to make it. I was on the team 2 years ago as well. And there was this girl that also wanted to try out. She was nice, very ugly, but nice nonetheless. And on the first day of practice before tryouts, I went over there just to get a good feel of if she was any threat to me or anyone else that's on the team. And she didn't have clubs. So I guess she just wanted to see if she was any good at golf. But there was no way that she could ever possibly make the team because, well, she didn't have clubs. So on the first day, everything went well. Coach was scouting for any new talent. And so, yeah, nothing major happened. But on the second day, he calls everyone over, and he says, "Oh, okay, guys, like, we've got a bunch of talent this year. Unfortunately, I can only take the best 11 or 12 of you guys. Since I'm the only golf coach, there's not going to be a JV team." And there was the girl that I was referring to you about and her friend, who was also trying out. "Sorry, you two girls, but there's no girls team either, so if you want to be on the team, you're going to have to beat the boys." So apparently, this girl, she takes it the wrong way, and what happens is she throws this huge fit. Her face is red as a beet, and she was getting so pissed, I just stayed away from her. I did not want to get involved with that, and she was just complaining about to her friend about how coach was sexist or whatever, and I was like, "Whoa, okay, I don't know what you're trying to say here, but you don't even have clubs, first of all. How can you expect to possibly make the golf team without clubs?" Now, that's not even the worst part, okay? She calls her mom in to talk to my coach about this. And my coach obviously knows why. The only reason she even came out here is just to have something else to write down for college. And her mom starts talking to coach, and she's like, "Well, you can't do this to my daughter. You shouldn't discriminate her, discriminate against her just because she's a girl or whatever." And my coach is like, "Look, we have a good team this year, and I want to make sure my best players start the matches that we're going to need to win if we want to win our conference," which we ended up doing so at the end. And coach was like, "Does your daughter play any other sports?" And to which the mom responded, "Yeah, she's first doubles in tennis." And coach responded with, "Well, what would you say if someone worse than her were to replace her for one of your tennis matches?" To which the mom responded, "Well, that's different." To which coach responded, "Actually, it's quite similar." Now, I'm minding my own business, and coach is trying to explain to us what she was trying to do. And I just could not stop laughing after he tells me the story the next day. And what happens is this girl goes up to me and she's like, "Matt, can you believe what coach said to me?" I was like, "What did he say to you?" Because at that point I didn't have the full story. And she was like, "Oh, he was so sexist. Did you hear him say, 'Oh, there's no girls team, so we can't make the team'?" To which I responded, "You're probably not going to miss the team due to the fact that you're a girl. You're going to miss the team because, well, first of all, you don't have clubs. And second of all, you can't play golf." You do know the acronym for golf, right?" To which he responds, "No, what is it? Guys only, ladies forbidden?" Which is obviously, I'm just joking around with her now. And she's like, she got so mad at that because apparently she's a feminist or some bullcrap or other, and she takes so much offense to that. She almost slapped me. I think she just got disgusted and just walked away. It was hilarious. Anyways, I'm at my limit. I hope you enjoyed my little story that I told you. And so yeah, expect more of these things in the future. I love that story. Oh my god. Yeah, so that's my story, and goodbye.